These zones, we have better permeability and porosity, so our testing protocols will be different than we've done in our other wells. They don't need the same kind of stimulation that we've done previously, so we're working on different protocols for these. And then, as Bob mentioned, we've got potentially three zones even above the Upper Prince Creek.
All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Jay Cheatham. He is the CEO of Pantheon Resources. And Jay, welcome back. Good to see you again.
Oh, Steve, it's always great. It's a pleasure to be with you again. Thank you.
Yeah, and also joining us is your technical director, Bob Rosenthal. Bob, great to see you as well.
Good to see you too.
So, Jay, let's start with you. You had a big announcement out from the company today along your Megrez-1 well, and exciting news for the company. Why don't you remind everyone a little bit about what that well is and really what the announcement was today?
Yeah, so that's a well drilling into our eastern topsets east of the Dalton Highway and the Trans-Alaska Pipeline. And the top line basically is, as we see an increase in the resource from our pre-drill estimate of 609 million barrels to increase by 15 to 50% over that pre-drill estimate in the Upper Schrader Bluff and the Prince Creek zones. And Steve, this is a well that Bob has wanted to drill ever since we merged the companies in 2019.
Yeah, Bob, let's talk about what you saw in this particular well and really give us sort of the technical view of what we're talking about today.
Well, if you could flash back to Jay for 1 second.
Yeah.
Because I love Jay's background picture.
I'll get out of the way so you can see it a little better.
So yeah. If you look back there's a feature called the Franklin Bluffs. And I think if we, in the past, if it would, the person who named that had called it the Franklin Fold, it would have a lot more of the geologic community would have been kind of saying, hey, there's something really interesting going on here. And what we have is a very big structural feature sitting there, a big fold sitting in the Foreland Basin. And that was the first thing that attracted us to this years and years and years ago, trying to understand what was going on. And the fact that we had done a massive amount of geochemical analysis of all the source rocks. And in particular, we believe that fold was sitting on top of the HRZ source rock where it was in peak oil generation, which is if you're an explorer, it gives you two out of three of the criteria of like drill a well here. So we were been excited about that for a very, very long time. The well has confirmed that we are that these source rocks are in peak oil generation. We've had that analysis from the isotope data. The work, the really, really excellent work done by AHS on our cuttings analysis is telling us the different reservoirs have oil in them as well. Our log analysis is telling us that. And as Jay has alluded to, our original target look like they're hydrocarbon bearing. We've got a couple of other zones above those original targets that, you know, we thought might be hydrocarbon bearing when we drilled the well, but we had not put those into the resource. They look like they're hydrocarbon bearing. And there's a potential for a few other zones above these, above what we call the Prince Creek, and they might be hydrocarbon bearing also. And we're working on the analysis as we speak to make that decision. But right now it's in our prognosis to probably test even those zones as well. So
yeah,
very, very big program.
Yeah, 15 to 15% upgrade in resource volume. That's pretty interesting announcement. That's a whopper one.
Well, first of all, the P50, we sort of our most likely case was already 600 million barrels, which is huge. You know, we would have been, you know, that would have been a fantastic result in and of itself. So yeah, it's looking very positive. Now we got to get out there and test the wells. test the zones in this well.
And Jay, that's really the next steps now, right? Is to do that, the testing that you need to do to sort of make sure you're on the right track here.
Yes, Steve. So as Bob mentioned, we will do four tests in the lower part in the Upper Prince Creek, Lower Prince Creek, and two in the Upper Schrader Bluff. These zones, we have better permeability and porosity, so our testing protocols will be different than we've done in our other wells. They don't need the same kind of stimulation that we've done previously, so we're working on different protocols for these. And then, as Bob mentioned, we've got potentially three zones even above the Upper Prince Creek that once we do some more diagnostics, we may choose to test those zones as well. And those look pretty exciting from what we've seen so far.
And lastly, Jay, just on getting to this particular point, I know it's a lot of work from Bob and his team, a lot of work from you and your team. It's a really strong day for Pantheon Resources.
Yes, it really is, and the market has done its job, and they see what we see so far, and there's actually more, potentially a lot more to come, Steve.
All right, we'll leave it there. Bob, thanks so much. Great to see you again, and appreciate your time today.
Sure. Thank you.
And as always, Jay, good to see you as well, my friend.
You too again, Steve. Thanks.
All right, Bob Rosenthal, Technical Director, Jay Cheatham, the CEO, both with Pantheon Resources.